Hi, I'm Ben Savage, and you're watching Clever TV.
Hey guys, I'm Jocelyn Davis with Dana Ward and Misty Kingma.
Hey!
And you probably guessed, but right now we are talking about Girl Meets World.
Yes, we are!
It's finally here!
Imagine that!
So, Girl Meets World just debuted on the Disney Channel. If you guys haven't tuned in yet, we're filling you in on 7 reasons why you need to. And our inner teenage selves are rejoicing because one of our all-time...
I am a teenager.
I know. I was going to be like, excuse me, I still am a teen.
I know. That's right. Yeah. You're 19. I always keep forgetting because you seem so mature. but one of our favorite all-time TV couples, Corey and Topanga.
My heart is from the past.
They're reprising their roles from Boy Meets World, mm-hmm. which aired from 1993 to the year 2000.
Craziness. You were barely even born, you guys.
I know. I was like 1 year old.
Me too. So you guys, the show focuses on Corey and Topanga's daughter, Riley Matthews. She's so cute. In very much the same way that Boy Meets World gave an inside look at Corey's life.
Right.
But do you guys know what's crazy?
What?
Rowan Blanchard, who plays Riley, we love her. She told us this about watching the original show that we all grew up with.
I wasn't even bored when the series had ended. So, but yes, I have seen all the episodes. I went back and I watched them all.
I mean, so it's not that surprising, but it was really funny to hear her say that she wasn't even born when the show stopped airing.
It's honestly
2000.
It's wild.
Okay, so another cool thing to note, my friends, is that the show is set in New York City, which, as you guys know, is where Corey and Topanga moved in the Boy Meets World series finale.
Duh.
Any fan knows that.
Yes.
And Corey has basically become the new Mr. Feeny because he's a teacher at his daughter Riley's school.
I love that.
So cool slash awkward. I love it.
And it gets better. Here's what kind of teacher Rowan Blanchard and Sabrina Carpenter told us he is.
Uh-oh.
Our pilot episode, we kind of pick up, it's like the beginning of the school year. Corey's her teacher, her history teacher. Very coincidental, every single lesson he teaches has to do with what's going on in our lives in the episode. I don't know how that happened, but it's really cool. He's, you know, he's met the world, so now he's just teaching us, and he does it in a very, very sneaky way, and sometimes we'll teach him, but most of the time it's him teaching us.
Okay, so I love the idea that Corey, aka Mr. Matthews, is a teacher at the school. I think it's such a cool twist.
It was meant to be, really.
It was.
And the profound lessons they're all learning from each other.
And that they might be teaching him
as
well.
It's so awesome.
But personally, I'm dying to see if he really does take on any of Mr. Feeny's traits. I don't know about you.
Like what? Sweaters over
sweaters,
glasses,
mustaches.
Calling his own daughter Ms. Matthews.
Like
he was called Mr. Matthews.
Yeah. Maybe he'll take on that accent when he says Ms. Matthews.
Hello, yes. And you guys are probably wondering who Sabrina Carpenter is playing because we haven't mentioned that yet.
Totes.
Because as you can tell, with Corey being like the new Mr. Feeny and Riley being the new Corey, there's a lot going on with the other characters. So who's the new Sean? And who's the new Topanga? And who's the new Minkus?
Questions.
Check it out.
Do you think your character is like anyone on Boy Meets World?
A little bit like Sean Hunter, which a lot of you have expected. Yeah, she's definitely the troublemaker, Maya, but it's cool because I get to interpret it in my own girl way. And, you know, coming into it, there was no, like, I had to be like Sean Hunter. It was just that's kind of who Maya is. That's mm-hmm. how she's described. And she has her own family problems. She's got her own issues in her head. But she's also very loyal to the Matthews family.
I think I'm really similar to Topanga.
So some romance, love on the show. Can you give us any tidbits?
I can give you a little bit. Me and Riley have a little connection.
Ooh, a romantic connection.
A
That's
romantic
exciting.
Connection, yeah.
I play Farkle, and he is the genius of the show. He's very smart. He loves learning.
What's 2 times 2?
4.
Well done.
See? Well just done. Like Farkle. But I think my favorite part of him is probably how much he values friendship, because I think that's really important. I am Minkus's son.
Okay, you guys, so let's get this straight. Ready?
Okay.
Stay with me. Okay, Sabrina's character Maya is the new Sean.
Okay.
Got it? Peyton's character Lucas is the new Topanga, aka love interest to Riley. And Corey's character, Farkle, is the new Minkus. And Farkle is actually Minkus's son.
This is so confusing!
Oh my gosh! I told you to stay with me!
I tried!
It's so confusing, but it's so awesome.
It is.
And after a few episodes, we'll all get the hang of it.
I hope so.
Definitely. And you guys can just keep rewatching this video so that you get it.
Rewind back.
And guys, don't worry, because Topanga is obviously still on the show. Thank goodness. And we can't forget to let you know that Corey and Topanga have another kid.
What?
A son named Augie, and he is so freaking
cute.
He's
so cute.
Oh my gosh, I just want to hug him. And speaking of cuteness, you guys need to know what is going to happen in the romance category on the show. And you need to know a little bit more about Lucas, obviously.
My character is Lucas Fryer, and he's the new kid in school. He's from Austin, Texas, so, you know, yes, sir, yes, ma'am.
Any y'alls in there?
And there is some y'alls in there. Yes, there is. And there's also some funny nicknames in there, too.
You'll see, but okay.
I mean, this one right here, Sabrina, gives me some funny nicknames.
You know, it's very innocent. Obviously, she's still in seventh grade, and the whole thing, really the first season, tells a lot about friendship, which is really, really cool. The friendship between these four characters, Farkle, Lucas, Maya, and Riley, is such a unique friendship that I'm really excited for people to see.
And such great names, too,
right?
By the way.
Farkle.
I am so excited to see this.
Don't hurt yourself.
Hey. But what I know everyone out there in TV land is excited about, especially all of my fellow Boy Meets World fans,
we're here,
is the list of guest stars and cameos that is about to come our way. Some knowledge bombs for you all. Check it.
My favorite moment from season one was probably bringing back all the Boy Meets World people. Mm-hmm. They brought back a lot to guest star on the show. It's really great meeting them and working with them. I'm really excited for everyone to see them.
Feeny's coming back, which is amazing. Ryder actually is coming back. He came back for a holiday episode. We had a bunch of people come back for that. We had Alan and Amy come back. Minkus plays Farkle's dad. Like a lot of the old cast members of Boy Meets World, like Ryder Strawn, William Rutz, Betsy Randall, we've had Jane Lynch, we've had Cloris Leachman, we've had Charlotte Ray. There's been so many great people that we were so lucky to work with.
Well, we've had Ryder Strong reprise his role as Sean, and I actually have a great scene with him where he's like, he sees Minkus in me, and he's like, oh, it's really funny.
Okay, so just to recap, pretty much everyone from the original show is coming back.
Yay!
Which is so great to see. Plus, Jane Lynch, hello, Glee, and Cloris Leachman, they're gonna be on season one, which is amazing.
Oh, I'm so excited.
Yay! And a lot of you guys out there are probably wondering what the show's going to be like now that it's on the Disney Channel.
Right.
A little switch up. And here's what the cast had to tell us about it.
But you have to remember the first season of Boy Meets World. You know, they were definitely kids, and we're kids. We're in seventh grade, so we're going through what seventh graders would go through. We're going through first crushes, you know, school dances, cafeteria work. We're going through getting Fs on papers, art class, paint fights, lots of stuff.
You could be 5 and you're excited, and you can be, you know, 30 and you're really excited. I mean, it's all a family show.
I think that's so true. I know there are 5-year-olds out there, and 30-year-olds, and 60-year-olds.
And 100-year-olds that are going to want to watch
it. And 200-year-olds.
And yeah, dogs. They're going to be coming out of the grave to tune in.
So, as you can tell, we're really excited about this show. We're dying to hear what you guys think. And we actually hit you guys up on Twitter to get your thoughts. And here's what you had to say.
First tweet that we loved is from Nelson at NCabero at Clever TV. Me, yes! Yes! So excited! And then I love this comment we got from Monica Muldrow. I can't wait for hashtag girl meets world. I loved hashtag boy meets world, and I think that it will be as awesome. And love you, Sabrina Carpenter.
That person knows their hashtags.
Good one.
Sarah Schultz said, at Clever TV, I'm seriously so excited I can jump in a pool of whipped cream.
Yes.
Can we do that anyway? And at LilyC123 said, at Clever TV, a sequel to my favorite show is the best. Can't wait to see Corey and Topanga.
DramaGirl1811 said, Boy Meets World was amazing. Can't wait to see what exciting stuff Girl Meets World has in store for fans. Smiley face. And then Sabrina and Rowan, oh my gosh, this person changed their name to be a fan of the show, said, I can't even wait. Ah, I know the show's gonna be awesome. That was all caps, P.S.
So some great comments from you guys. Thank you, P.S. And ladies, I just need to know, just for nostalgia's sake, what was your favorite memory, your favorite moment from Boy Meets World?
This is so easy for me. I'm going to go first because I'm so excited about this one. Okay, Corey and Topanga's first kiss.
Oh, the
remember feels. They're handcuffed to the locker and she like pins him up and just kisses him and then reveals to him afterwards that it was her first kiss too.
Oh, so cute.
Right? You just brought me back and I'm blushing.
Stop, Dana.
So cute. I have to say, this is kind of a reoccurring thing, but when Eric would do the Mr. Feeny call.
Oh my gosh.
Feeny.
Okay.
I love the Feeny call.
Yes.
Pretty funny.
Love it. Okay, well, for me, I have to say, I just get so emotional thinking about this. Topanga was my hairspiration, continues to be my hairspiration.
Topanga's hair!
That's pretty
everything.
Literally, it looked like she put it into braids at night and it came out looking perfect.
The crimp.
The like evolution of her
hair. Mermaid hair.
Yes, exactly. The evolution of Topanga's hair truly altered my style.
All of us, I really think it's influenced, like, our culture.
I agree. In the world.
Deep rooted.
Deep thoughts.
Yes. But Deep thoughts USA over here.
Right.
Over.
But we want to hear from you guys, so let us know what you loved about the show, if you tuned in for the big premiere, and let us know what you're excited to see, because I think there's a lot coming down the pipeline with Girl Meets World.
Girls Rule.
I can't wait to see. Girls Rule, Boys Drool.
Yeah.
Corey Matthews. And you guys, make sure you check out 7 Things You Need to Know About the Fosters Season 2. Just click right here.
Awesome!
How'd we do?
I think it was great. How did you feel about it?
I thought it went really, really well. I'm very excited about it.
I think you could be hired if you
want. Please hire me. Let me know.